Hello children, today we are going to do the civics first lesson for the 7th standard students, that is our constitution. Our constitution, what does it mean? Have you heard of the word constitution? You have already studied about constitution in your previous class. What does the constitution mean? Constitution means a set of basic rules. What is the meaning of constitution? A set of basic rules followed by a fundamental. So it is not an easy job to the earlier there were smaller kingdoms, but to run a whole country the government has to work accordingly. So to work for the betterment of a country, there are certain rules which are set up in our constitution. So constitution is nothing but a set of basic rules followed by a country. It meaning is that, and in this lesson we are going to learn various competencies. First we are going to see what understanding the meaning and importance of the constitution. So in this lesson you will be knowing what does the constitution means and why is it important that a constitution has to be framed to administer to follow the administration of the, how to run the administration of a country. Then next is understanding the preamble of the constitution. Again, preamble means the introduction, the introduction speech, preamble. So how is that being done? Yeah, you have to understand in this, it will be told you. The next is understanding the salient features of the constitution and appreciated the different elements which have been spoken about here in the constitution. You will learn them and try to appreciate them. Then one more, next we are having the understanding the profile of persons who were involved in drafting of the constitution. Like you all know about who is our father of the constitution, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So along with him, many others who were the persons involved in the framing of our constitution, we will be learning about them also. The next three competencies are understanding the concept of the republic. Our country is became republic on January 26, 1950. We celebrate our Republic Day. So what is the main aim? We understanding the concept of the republic. What does it actually mean, the country to become republic? And then understand the need for strengthening ourselves in adopting the principle of secularism in our daily life. Secularism means, you have already learned that also, socialism and secularism last year. Secularism means the people belonging to any religion. They live together, united in one country. So that principle, how, in what way, it makes us more full of strength. It gives strength to our life and in adopting the principle of secularism in our daily life. If we try to think in a way that all religions are equal, then in what way it will affect our life, we are going to learn in this. And then developing the attitude to respect the constitution. So whatever is being given by the government, the law, that has to be given respect and followed properly. That is the main important thing. Whatever is being said in the constitution, that has to be given respect and followed by each one of its citizens. Now to know the first thing, the lesson is after the competencies, we will start with the meaning and importance of a constitution. As you all know, I said what does a constitution mean? It is a set of basic rules followed by a country. So a set of rules, set for a rule that has to be followed by a country. And it function is, it enumerates the organs of the government, its powers and functions. So about the government, the different organs you have learned previously also last year, that is the legislature, the executive and the judiciary, which are the three organs of the government. One by one we will learn, try to tell you what are its powers, what powers are there in the organs, and how does it function, the different powers of the different organs of the government, namely legislature, executive and judiciary, and what are their powers and how does it function. That it will tell you, it shows you one by one, and a reference to the rights and duties of the citizens. So what is mentioned in that, the rights of the citizens and the duties of the citizens are clearly mentioned, which has to be followed by every citizen of the country. It tells you that, and it is also a reference guide to the government, how the government has to carry on the administration. All mentioned, the rules are mentioned hereby. That is why it is also known as a reference guide to the government. So this gives you the meaning and importance of the constitution. Now, to know the importance of a constitution, as already we discussed in the competencies in the starting of the lesson, here we are going to see that it is very prominent, means very important for the progress of the country. It is prominent as it is the fundamental law of the country, that has been laid as a law. Laws are made to be followed. Okay, so it is the fundamental law of the country. Constitution is the fundamental law of the country, and all people, not only the normal citizens, all people including the president, the prime minister, the parliamentarians, the people, MLAs and MPs who are considered as parliamentarians, who are the members of the parliament, the parliamentarians, the judges and officers, all are bound by it. So no, there is no different rule for seeing the post or anything. A higher post will have a different set of rules. It is not at all like that. The laws laid by the constitution are same whether he is a president or a prime minister or a member of a parliament or any judge or an officer. He is just a citizen of the country. So laws are same for each one of them. So that's why that is the main importance of our constitution. And what are its functions already? That means it protects the rights of the citizens to whichever religion they belong to, but the rights are equal, laid by the law. And it functions as a reference guide to the the duties of the government. So all that time, if some decision had to be taken by the government, it tries to refer the constitution and go according to it, and it coordinates the functions of the organs of the government, as mentioned earlier, the different organs, the legislature, the executive, the judiciary. These organs, how it runs accordingly, one by one, it tries to coordinate the functions of each one of them. And lastly, it organizes better relations between the government and the individual. So there should be certain kind of a relation between the government and the citizen. So it tries to lay the rights which are mentioned in the constitution. According to that, there is certain relation between the government and the citizen. Now as we are talking about the constitution, one thing we have to know about is the most known person, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. He was known as the father of our constitution. That means he framed the constitution. He belonged to a scheduled caste family, that is from the lower caste family. But he was so knowledgeable, and then his contribution to frame our constitution is always remembered with due respect by every citizen of our country. So for the work he has done to frame the constitution, which took around 4 to 5 years, we always remember him, and he is being called as the father of our constitution. Now about the drafting committee of the constitution, that was the people involved in framing the constitution. The constituent assembly, which is of 299 members, prepared the constitution, and the first session of the constituent assembly was held on 9th December 1946. The first session of constituent assembly, it was held on 9th December 1946. We got, as if you remember, when we got our independence, 1947. So earlier to that, the first session of constituent assembly was held in 9th December 1946, and the first president of India was the president of this constituent assembly was Dr. Rajendra Prasad, who is also became the first president of independent India. Later, he was declared as the president for constituent assembly in 1946, and later in 1947 he was declared as the first president of India also. And the chairman of the drafting committee, the chairman, and also known as the law minister of India. Who was it? Law minister as well as the chairman of drafting committee was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So if a question has been asked, who is the law minister of India? It is B.R. Ambedkar. Who was the chairman of the drafting committee? It was Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Who was the president of the first session of constituent assembly? Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Who was the first president of independent India? Is also Dr. Rajendra Prasad. You have to remember two things of these two important people. And it took around 3 years to get its final shape. The constitution, to get its final shape, it took almost 3 years. So, as I said, the constituent assembly was of 299 members. The adoption of constitution was on 26th January 1950. So you all are familiar with this date because it is celebrated as a Republic Day. Republic Day, and it is considered to be the one of the national festivals. And why is this remembered? Because of the adoption. The adoption of constitution started on this date. Then there is another constitutional day that is celebrated every year, but it was on 26th November 1949. That is the day when it was approved by the Constituent Assembly. The Constitution, the set of rules which were framed, it was approved by the Constituent Assembly, that considered of 299 members. By them it was approved on which day? 26th November 1949. And every year it is being celebrated, not nationally, but it is celebrated as Constitutional Day. So when is the Constitutional Day? Means you have to remember this day. 26th November 1949. And the first general elections of India were held during the year 1951-52. The first general elections. And the parliament was bicameral. Bicameral means is considered of two houses, the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. It became into two parts, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, which we will learn later on. Which members include in these both houses, and that was in 1952 again. So during that general elections, this 1952, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha, the parliament was bicameral, means two. Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, I am talking about the size of our constitution. What does it include? How many points? How many articles? Means it contains 395 articles and 12 schedules. 395 articles and 12 schedules. You have to remember these two numbers. 395 articles and 12 schedules. Now coming to the preamble of the constitution. Preamble means the introductory words or the beginning, the speech which is there. That is known as the preamble of the constitution. The beginning. That is considered as the heart of the constitution. Why is it considered? Because it represents the dreams and ideologies of the people. What are the different dreams? It gives reference to the ideologies of the people, namely justice, freedom, equality, self-respect, fraternity, and national. national integrity. These are the ideologies which the preamble of the constitution refer or represents to. Now I will just show you the preamble from the text, children. When you get the script, it will be very easy to look at it. But here in the video, I will just try to show you the preamble of the of our constitution. You can see that the preamble of our constitution, preamble in the present form. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic, republic and secure to all its citizens. Justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our constitution, as a constituent assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this constitution. So this is known as the preamble of our constitution. Now we are going to learn about why our constitution is considered as a unique one. Unique one means the only one all over the world. Why is first thing is it is a written constitution. It is the lengthiest constitution which is in a written form. No other country of the world has got a constitution such a lengthiest. So this is the lengthiest constitution of the world. It consists of the powers and the extent of powers of different organs of the government, such as the legislature, the executive, the judiciary, all are coming under this written form of the constitution. So it is known as the lengthiest. So because and it does not have it is a single constitution which has got the rules for both the central government as well as the state government. There is no different constitution for different states. India has got so many states, but the constitution is for both the central as well as the state. So it is considered as a big one, the lengthiest one constitution. That is one thing. The next is republic. It is got a republican system. Republican system means it is our India is called as a democratic republic. Democratic country, democratic republic. Why is it considered republic? Means it does not work under a king. Earlier how it was, the kings used to rule, but it has become a democratic republic. What does it say? It is being ruled by the elected representatives, by the elected representatives. That's why it is considered to be a our country is considered to be a democratic republic. As I have said, our Republic Day is on 26th January 1950. So that time it became a democratic country. That means the country is run by the elected representatives in the elections. Next comes the fundamental rights and duties which are mentioned in our constitution. There are six fundamental rights. As per the government has mentioned in the constitution, six fundamental rights. These fundamental rights, the state has got no. If it tries to curb with the laws of the fundamental laws, the state, the judiciary has got the right to rectify it. So no state can go against any of the fundamental rights of the citizens that is mentioned in our constitution. And every citizen has his responsibility that he has to, whatever rights he has got according to the constitution, he he cannot go according to his will and wish and use those rights and try to malpractice it. So the and so they are as said there are six fundamental rights, six fundamental rights and 11 fundamental duties. You know, 11 fundamental duties are mentioned in our constitution. So that is about the fundamental rights and duties. Next is the secularism. Our country is known as a secular country. That means the importance is given to all religions which are staying in our country. There is no religion of the constitution. It the constitution upholds the principle of secularism, saying that there is no religion, no religion for a secular country, and the citizens are given to follow their own religion of their choice and faith. But they cannot take advantage of it. The government has been given the thing to stop wherever it has crossed its limit in the interest of the public. So they have got the choice to follow their own religion, whichever they like, according to their choice and faith. But that can be controlled by the government in the interest of public if it is crosses any kind of limit, any limit. Next, we have the independent judiciary. What does it mean is, the judiciary is one of the organ of the government, which has got three organs, namely legislature, executive and judiciary. So we have, here we are having independent judiciary, which is independent of the other two organs, namely legislature and the executive, and has got its adequate powers. No one can interfere to the decision of the court of law and try to change it. So independent judiciary means that is the meaning. So nobody has got the right to change its decision. Whatever the Supreme Court takes a decision, that has to be followed by everyone, and everyone has to adhere by it. That is meaning of independent judiciary. The sixth one, we are having a constitution which is having the universal adult franchise. What does it mean is, the system of electing the representative by voting of adult members, that is 18 years and above, is called universal adult franchise. So there is no discrimination shown here. All citizens have got the right to cast their vote to whichever representative they want to. So and 18 years and above, every citizen of the country, each citizen of the country who is 18 years and above have got the right to vote. That is called universal adult franchise. Now coming to the election system, India has got the largest democracy in the world. In the past 6 decades, periodic elections have been conducted. Periodic elections, every 5 years the elections have been conducted. You all must have seen your elders go to cast their vote. Periodic elections have been conducted in our country, and then in this democratic system has adequately deep-rooted in our country. Deep-rooted means it has continuously been going on this way, the elections taking place and the representative being elected. It has deep-rooted in our country. So it is still a satisfactory system in spite of certain demerits. Our country has become is satisfied with what kind of democratic things that a democratic system that means in that is being followed in our country, in spite of it certain demerits. So if I have explained to you all these unique features of our constitution is a written one, which shows it is the lengthiest in the world. Then republic, because our country is known as a democratic republic, that is no rule of king, and whoever is been elected, the rule comes in his hands, the elected representative, and the fundamental rights and duties that has to be followed by the citizens, and nobody else has got the right to come with it. And then the independent judiciary, which is independent of the other two organs, and whatever the Supreme Court takes the decisions, that has to be followed by all that. And then about the universal adult franchise, that every citizen who is 18 years and above have got the right to cast its vote, that type of system. That's why it's called a universal adult franchise. And the election system. So periodically the elections which have been conducted in the country, that has been followed in our country. So these features make our constitution a unique one. A unique one. So children, here ends our lesson, our constitution. So go through, just listen to it carefully again and again. If something you have not understood during this explanation, write and keep your doubts, and when we will have a Google meet, we will discuss about your doubts and clear for you. Thank you.